Heads up, Doug just released a 42 minutes podcast with Jake Kotza talking about the 10-year anniversary of the Sinkhole blog. Holy shit, 10 years! Time is flying by, and for me, right now, that's kind of a problem. I really, from a life perspective, should not be making this episode right now. I took the day off from work to pack up since I move apartments in 5 days. But this data has been piling up so fast and so intensely, I need to get some of it out now before it becomes even more unwieldy. So let's do this as quick as we can. So the last time I put one of these out was April 9th, where I harped on the symbolism of the Lion King and broken legs and the 2011 Easter to May Day mega ritual. And exactly one day after, I'm like, yo, for real, pay attention to the Lion King. What the fuck happens with the release of the new Lion King trailer?
I'm not only gonna show you my birth certificate, I'm gonna show you a video of my live birth. And he shows a video from Disney's Lion King. And then on Sunday reports that he killed Osama bin Laden. In Arabic, Osama means lion. In Japanese, it means king. So here you have Barack Obama presenting himself as the Lion King, saying, I've killed the Lion King, I am the Lion King. The king is dead, long live the king.
Right? That's pretty much the Sing equivalent of, you sunk my battleship. Touche universe, you've got my attention. But then, on April 12th, that's 3 days after the last Sing quick news, my good friend Kira Young breaks her fucking leg. Now, my heart goes out to her. That sucks. But also, the fact that she was just featured in a Sing Quick News about a month ago is an undeniable confirmation for me that either we are hyper in sync with this archetypal flare-up, or that my sloppy chaos magic is even sloppier than I suspected, and now I'm accidentally hurting my friends. I sure hope it's not the latter, but Kira, my deepest apologies just in case. Anyway, on April 14th, we saw this theme turn from lions to tigers, with this Easter foreshadowing, over-the-top, Jesus-laced Tiger Woods comeback story. 6 days later, on April 20th, there's a tiger attack in Kansas, again signaling Oz. Sybil Hunter found this Tiger Woods headline about his broken body. Again, remember all our broken leg themes. She then combines these two stories of Tiger's broken body and the tiger chewing on the human under the Christian theme of a Eucharist. Quote, while they were eating, Jesus took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take and eat, this is my body. But this story also foreshadows the return of the Obama-Trump Lion King ritual into our conversation, as both presidents felt the need to publicly comment on Tiger's comeback. And that conversation returned between these two Tiger events when the heavily redacted Russiagate Mueller report was released on April 18th. So we had lions and tigers, but what is that commonly used symbol for Russia? I'm trying to remember. That's right, Russia is the bear.
Lions and tigers and bears, oh my!
Lions and tigers and bears,
oh my!
Lions and tigers and bears,
oh my!
Lions and tigers and bears,
oh my!
Lions and tigers and bears,
oh my!
Oh Jesus, I just googled Russian bear and got this fucking thing. Anyway, while in my opinion this whole Russiagate thing was a ruse and part of a diversion tactic to actually keep Trump in power, maybe repaying a favor when Trump floated his outlandish conspiracy theory about Kenya and birth certificates that actually helped Obama, and as a nice little bonus gave us our whole Lion King theatrics in the first place. We could talk more about the practicalities of all that another time, but at least on the surface, the Russiagate thing was ostensibly about impeaching Trump, removing him from power. And therefore, it is symbolic of our King Kill motif. Now, there were a few other big-ass stories that happened last week, notably the Notre Dame fire on April 15th. Look, there's just so much data that's already been compiled, I'm gonna mostly skip this story. If you're unaware of a lot of the work that's been done in the last 10 days, check out the Kitchen Sink Facebook group. Lauren Coleman, Goro Adachi, Andrew Griffin, Sybil, and so many others have dug deep, and there's a ton of conversation and whatnot there. Just a few things I want to add. When even the artificial intelligence algorithms confuse this event with 9/11, we know something's up. Obviously, that correlation gets played with for political reasons, and my spidey senses go off a bit. But let's acknowledge the weirdness of the fact, not only was there a fire at a major Muslim holy site at the same exact time, but the morning of the Notre Dame fire saw lightning strike the World Trade Center. This huge echo of 9/11 is preceded by Max Julian. Wait. Really? The guy who filmed this thing has the same name as the mayor of New York City on 9/11? Really? Okay, so where was I? So this huge echo of 9/11 is preceded by Max Giuliani filming a lightning strike of its symbolic twin? Remember, I did an entire Sync Quick News. It was number 17, go look it up and watch it, about the significance of lightning striking the World Trade Center as a symbolic motif incorporated into 9/11 itself. I think this is a huge note, but hey, that's just me. Now, obviously we have the theme of the destroyed temple echoing throughout this month. We have the church fires in Louisiana, fires that were attacks on black churches set by the racist son of a sheriff's deputy. Gee, I wonder why that didn't make the news cycle. Then we have the Sri Lanka church bombings on Easter itself. Now, not only does this story name-check the tiger motif again with its comparison to the Tamil Tiger Organization, but the bombings took place in Colombo, Sri Lanka, the day after the 20th anniversary of the Columbine shooting. Colombo and Columbine share the same Latin root, columba, which means dove. The dove is a potent symbol used by many religious groups, though Christianity dominates the symbol nowadays, as it does most things. But as a constellation, the Columba dove is associated with the Sirius grouping that so often comes up in relation to Isis and Osiris. I have more I want to say on that, but we'll leave it there for now. Let's just bring in this one note that Will Morgan tipped us off to. Columbine resurgence from a woman named Saul. Yes, as in the sun, it is Easter week after all, and her Paris-inducing name. Oh, do you guys remember Sync Quick News number 12, where we talked about Paris? Paris, obviously in the news because of Notre Dame.
Well, did you know that Paris is named after ISIS? And this shooting took place very close to the January 20th anniversary of Napoleon issuing written instructions that the Egyptian goddess and her star be included on the French capital city's coat of arms.
But okay, so if we're going to talk about Easter at all, it is important to remember that if we go back to that Easter week from April of 2011...
One week before, was Easter, right? This is the day that Jesus is to rise from the grave. This is the rebirth of the king. Then on Wednesday, Barack Obama introduces his birth certificate, which is essentially a symbolic rebirth himself.
Of course, the day before Friday is the alchemical royal wedding over there in England. Very important also, but we don't have time to get into that.
At the same time that Obama was announcing himself as the Lion King while ostensibly saying to Donald Trump, hey, I wasn't born in Kenya. There was also a royal wedding of William and Kate. Note that the couple originally got engaged in Kenya. Again, the completion of their engagement, which began at the bottom of a mountain in Kenya, is followed the next day by Obama jokingly showing himself being born in Kenya atop a mountain. Fast forward to this week, news that the other royal couple, Meghan and Harry, might move to Africa is announced during the Royal Easter Sunday church service, which also just happens to be the same day that the Queen turned 93. The Queen turns 93 on Easter Sunday. That's so low-hanging fruit right there. Just insert Crowleyan conspiracy theory of your choice here. Oh! But who wasn't at church celebrating Thelemic Queen Jesus' rebirth day? Meghan, the soon-to-be African princess, because she's literally about to crap out their next messianic hopeful any day now. This fucking week, really? Hey, that's like three births in one. And finally, we end today's catch-up with a story that just happened yesterday. We've talked so much about king kills and all that symbology, but we just got an actual king kill in Texas with the execution of total piece of shit, John William King. While I am not an advocate of state-sanctioned execution just on principle, I think it's fairly safe to say this king kill is one that might put the good in your Good Friday.